So let's talk about glands that are specific to the integumentary system or to the skin. We will go into way more detail considering glands in the endocrine portion of the MOOC, but I want to introduce some that are specific to this area and just a quick overview. What is a gland? Well, glands are going to be a collection of epithelial cells or epithelial tissue that are going to secrete something. All right, so there's two main types. There's endocrine, and as its name would suggest, it's going to release the secretion into the bloodstream or just the interstitial fluid within the body, so staying within the body. Exocrine is going to be released onto a surface, okay? So in our case, obviously the surface is going to be the skin or out to the external environment. You can also have the oral cavity, so the mucous membrane associated with the oral cavity when you talk about salivary glands in subsequent lectures. So we're going to be focusing, obviously, in this specific section on exocrine glands. So there's two main types of glands associated with, or two main categories of glands associated with the integumentary system. And we're going to start with sebaceous glands, and a lot of times we just refer to these as oil glands because that's what it's releasing. It's releasing what's referred to as sebum, or secreting sebum, which is basically an oily secretion. And as you can see here, we're looking at this specific picture here. You have a sebaceous gland, and importantly, it is associated with the hair follicle. So almost always you're going to have the sebaceous gland associated with a hair follicle, so it will release or secrete its secretion and be able to kind of lubricate the hair. That's also going to be on the external surface, or the shaft of the hair, which is on the external surface of the skin. Now, sebaceous glands typically in younger individuals are fairly inactive. Once an individual reaches adolescence or puberty, then they become larger, they secrete more. You can have infection sometimes in the little region where it does secrete. That can lead to acne. So that's what's associated with the sebaceous glands. All right, so the other main category of the exocrine glands associated with the integumentary system are sudoriferous, what we typically refer to as sweat glands. And you have so many sweat glands associated with your skin. And when we think of sweat glands, typically we're thinking of eccrine. These are by far the most numerous. And these are really important in terms of thermoregulation. So when we think of sweat, we think of that water-like, odorless sweat that we secrete throughout the body. These are these eccrine glands. Eccrine is actually a misnomer. That's not actually how it's released, but we're not going to go into those details. But this is what you'll see in most textbooks. The other type of sweat gland is an apocrine. These are far less numerous. They're in specific areas of the body. So you're going to have them associated with the armpit or the axillary region, beard region, as well as in terms of external genitalia. And you will have these sweat glands be activated in times of sexual excitement, embarrassment, and these are going to have an odor associated with them. So it's considerably less numerous than your eccrine glands, and they have fairly different functions as opposed to one another. So these are the main ideas I want you to understand in terms of the glands. We'll come back to these in later discussions of the endocrine system.